Welcome to the Strategy Driven Podcast. Make the mission measurable. Hi, I'm Nathan Ives, along with my co-host, Howard Dickens. We would like to welcome you to this edition of the Strategy Driven Podcast, Make the Mission Measurable. The Strategy Driven Podcast focuses on the tools and techniques managers and executives can use to improve their organization's alignment and accountability to ultimately achieve better results. These podcasts elaborate on the best practice and warning flag posts on the Strategy Driven website at www.strategydriven.com. This podcast examines the strategic planning best practice of making the mission measurable, thereby creating a clear objective for decisions of all types made at all levels of the organization. And so without further delay, let's get started.
Hi, Nathan. How you doing?
Hey, my friend. I'm doing very good. How are you tonight, Howard?
I'm doing super. Doing super. Had a wonderful day. I mean, I just couldn't ask for a better day.
Outstanding. Outstanding.
How's the family?
Family is outstanding. Family is doing real good. Got all the girls tucked off to bed right now, so kind of quiet around the house.
All right. Well, I only have one baby, and she's tucked away, too.
All right.
Well, hey, you want to go ahead and get started?
I think we should.
Okay. Well, I tell you, I've got a big question here for you. I mean, and I'm sure our listeners, once they find out where we're going with this, they'll appreciate some of my questions. What is a mission statement?
Okay, well, I'm glad you asked. You know, mission statements are really critically important to an organization because they define what the organization's purpose is. They specify the need that the organization's going to fill, the benefit that it's going to be providing. And then it really gets down and focuses on who's going to be the receiver of those benefits. So let me give you an example. If we were to talk about Merck & Company, and in this case, I am referring to that large pharmaceutical company I think probably most of our listeners are familiar with. If you go to Merck's website, you'll see that Merck's stated mission is to provide society with superior products and services by developing innovations and solutions that improve the quality of life and satisfy customer needs, and to provide employees with meaningful work and advancement opportunities, and investors with a superior rate of return. So now if we kind of broke that apart, we would see that Merck really has three purposes stated within their mission statement. So the first purpose is the need to improve quality of life, and they're going to do that by developing superior products and services to meet the needs of society. And I think the other important point to make here is that notice, you know, Merck specifies that they're going to satisfy customer needs. So really what they're saying there is they're not going to be a not-for-profit company. They're going to have paying customers. So, you know, that's kind of a clear flag to us that they're going to be a for-profit organization.
Okay.
So now then they have the second purpose. And that second purpose is they're going to provide meaningful work and advancement opportunities. So here the beneficiaries are the Merck employees. So this now is looking internal to the organization. And by saying they're going to provide meaningful work and advancement opportunities, you know, I really take that as a statement of accountability. And I know we talked about that in our last podcast about what it means to be strategy driven.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So, but here, meaningful work and advancement opportunities is what they're going to provide. The benefit and the beneficiaries are the employees. The last one, and I think this is really very true of all for-profit companies, is in this case, Merck, as a publicly traded company, they have shareholders. They need to provide a return on investment to those shareholders. So here, the return on the investment is the benefit, and the beneficiaries are going to be the company investors, whether they own corporate stock, whether they own bonds in the company, or what have you. That third purpose is to really enrich those who actually own the company.
That's good, Nathan. You know, we're talking about what makes a mission measurable, and I asked you, what's a mission statement? And that was really, really on point. That was, and I think we all have an idea, or at least we think we know what a mission statement is. But let me ask you something else. If the mission statement provides the organization with a sense of purpose, why make it measurable?
Ooh, that is a great question. And first off, I'm going to use a phrase that sounds cliche, but it's just so true.
Okay.
And it can be one of a couple. You know, if you can't measure it, you can't manage it. That and whatever gets measured gets done. Kind of corollary to that is whatever gets measured and rewarded gets done well. And I think these phrases kind of together speak to why we want to make the mission measurable.
Okay.
So the mission statement in and of itself, and even in Merck's case, is really broad, and it could mean so many different things. You know, Merck is a pharmaceutical, but if I didn't know that, and I'm just developing superior products and services that, you know, benefit the public, I could be making a lot of different things. And so, as part of being strategy driven, we have to provide clarity to that. We have to provide enough clarity that we can focus the organization on achieving those very specific goals, that we can translate that down through the organization into the actions and decisions people make on a day-to-day basis. So by making the mission measurable, mm-hmm. we actually better define it into not setting the goals, but the measurements for which the goals are going to be set at.
Okay. That's good.
So now we have with these goals, we have clarity. We have clarity so that when we see or have to go after a decision, you know, do we make product A or do we make product B? We can use the measure as a backdrop and say, okay, if my goal is to enrich investors, which one of these two products is going to better enrich my investors? If my goal is to provide products and services to the community that betters their quality of life, and in this case, these are pharmaceutical products, which of these two am I as an organization going to be able to pursue that is going to better enable us as an organization to improve the quality of life of the general community? And so it starts to shape that target. It gives definition to the target, so it helps us make those strategic decisions that launch us on our way to later on selecting the projects and the initiatives and the processes that ultimately, allow us to be strategy driven, to focus our organization to the that central goal, that mission, that vision that we want to have all of our employees pulling with their maximum towards.
That's really good. So, a measurable mission. It clarifies the company's goals. But Nathan, how does it make the organization strategy driven?
Well, Howard, here I'm going to start out with a confession. Confession being good for the soul,
Okay.
huh? Making the mission measurable in and of itself really doesn't make an organization strategy driven. What it really does is it helps clarify the vision so that you can then pick the products and the services that you want to go ahead and pursue. So in our last podcast, we talked about what made an organization strategy driven, and we said shared vision, and then we said focus, and we said a commitment. Well, making the mission measurable helps create the focus because it focuses that target. It provides definition to the target to which all members of the organization are acting to fulfill.
That's
So
good.
just yeah, so decision makers are making decisions that'll best fulfill the vision. Well, they have to have a good focus on that target. Yeah, so making the mission measurable helps create a strategy-driven organization because it helps bring into focus the shared vision. And so by itself, it really doesn't make an organization strategy driven. Without it, though, it's going to be awful difficult for an organization to be strategy driven. And I guess if it was a standalone item, we'd have a really short podcast series. So, given we have a long way to go, this is just one of the important ones to talk about up front.
Oh boy, that's funny right there. Now listen now. Now we agree that making the mission measurable is worthwhile. We agree with that, right?
Yeah, we agree. We're good.
But how would one really go about doing it?
And that's a great question. And this is an important item. I've got 7 steps that we need to follow, and I'm just going to walk us through those, and we'll talk about why each one is important.
All right, I got my pen and pad out.
Okay, we're ready to go then.
All right.
Okay, the first one is in making the mission measurable, we really need to have a sponsor. And the sponsor that we have to get is really the CEO. If we're translating this down into, and I certainly would recommend, business units and departments, for instance, having missions. If you're a department, and you're making a mission and you want to translate the activities down, it could be the department manager. It's whoever the senior manager is for the organization for whom the mission statement applies. But for our discussion, I'm going to assume that it's for the whole company. And so the senior manager for the whole company is the CEO. And the reason it needs to be the CEO is it's this individual is the only one that has the ability to then say, this is what we as an organization are committed to, and reinforce that across the entire organization. If it was a subordinate, then they're trying to get their peers to buy in. And everyone having a little bit different experience and background is not always going to interpret the same words in the same way. And so you get distortions to what these mission measures are. Really needs to be the top person. So that's the first one. Sponsorship by the senior organization manager. The next one is that we need to form a cross-disciplinary team to form, to put together these measures that are going to then be proposed and later on approved by our executive sponsor. The reason a cross-disciplinary team is so important is these measures have to be translatable to each component or each business unit within our organization. And everyone's a little different. You know, we have some line organizations and we have some supporting organizations. And it's equally important that our support organizations understand how they are contributing to achieving those organizational mission goals, just like the line organization. Mm-hmm. And in order to be able to have that knowledge and understanding of how they translate, to get the buy-in to how they translate, you really need involvement. And so it's important here in our second step that we put together a team that's going to create these mission measures, that the team is comprised of people representing all the various disciplines across the organization. So that's step two, cross-discipline team.
Got it.
Step three, we need to break the mission statement apart and examine its major components. Now, as a for instance, you know, we looked at Merck, mm-hmm. and we broke right. Merck's up into three components.
Right.
As I think of this, generically speaking, I often see three components, but maybe a little different than what Merck's is. But mission statements often have the following three components. And they are a statement of what the company provides and to whom, a statement about the contribution it's going to make to, I'll call them, stakeholders.
Okay.
And this is employees and investors, because employees are stakeholders. And that's why I use that term instead of shareholders.
Sure.
Because it's both. The last one I see in a lot of mission statements is a statement of societal contribution. So giving back to the community is of high importance for many of our companies nowadays. And we see that. You know, we're a nation here in the U.S., where we have a lot of philanthropic efforts, we have a lot of charitable giving, and organizations embody that in their mission. Mm-hmm. So that's kind of the third component. So it's a statement of what the company provides and to whom, a statement of its contribution to its stakeholders, both the investors and the employees, and then finally, the societal contribution. And so that's step three, breaking the mission statement apart into its major components.
Okay, got it. That's okay. Good.
Okay. Step four is identifying the measures for each one of those statements. Mm-hmm. And really what's important here, we're going to start out by we'll create, you know, probably quite a number of measures for each one of these mission statement parts. But now as we move into step five, where appropriate, we want to start combining those back together again.
Mm.
The mission measures really need to be easily understood.
Okay.
And so we don't want to have 100 mission measures. Optimally, and we'll talk about this in podcasts down the road, we'd like to have three. And really that's suggesting one mission measure for each one of our mission components if we have three.
Mm.
So in step four, we're going to define everything to paint that whole picture.
Okay.
In step five, we're going to do some combination, and we may create what I'll call an index, a measure that by itself combines maybe several measurements together, kind of like the consumer price index combines a lot of you know, the change in cost of a lot of different products together to come up with an index.
Mm-hmm.
We may use indexes, but in the fifth step, we're combining as appropriate to try to get the number down to three at most.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Number six gets us back to what we talked about before, is our executive sponsor has to approve the measures. Again, it's only that person that sits at the top that's going to be able to drive accountability to the measures and make them uniformly applicable across the entire organization. If we don't have that, we'll have, as we discussed earlier, fragmented implementation, because just because we're human, we'll have different interpretations of what the measures mean. And so everyone will apply them differently.
Sure.
Yeah. The last one, and this is if not the most important step, it's right up there. And we got to communicate.
Amen, brother.
Oh, yeah. And, you know, I hear this from time to time where you're sitting in meetings with executives and they'll say something like, you know, I just don't understand it, but all I ever get asked is, what's my vision of where the company's going?
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, or what do I think? Or can we meet with this other executive and understand what direction this executive thinks the company's going? You know, what does she want us to do? What does she see our shortfalls as? What that tells me is that there's not enough communication going on, that we haven't communicated well enough to create the clarity needed that the organization understands that, okay, this is the target. This is what I need to focus my actions and decisions on achieving. And if you don't have that clarity and understanding down to the individual contributor level of the organization, we're not going to be strategy driven. We're not going to have people mm-hmm. that are able to commit because we don't have the focus we need
right.
for them to know what to commit to. So that's it. Seven steps.
Okay. Let's see, let me go over my notes here. This was really good stuff, Nathan. Let's see
okay.
if I can put this in a nutshell here. A mission statement or a mission is a statement of the organization's purpose. What
yep.
needs
yep.
what need it will fulfill, and who will benefit.
That's correct.
That's correct.
All That's right. correct. Right on the money.
Making the mission measurable is critical to the strategy-driven organization, because it defines the mission in a way that provides objective clarity to decision-making and provides a basis for assessing the organization's success. All right?
Yes.
Okay.
Absolutely. Good. Absolutely.
Mission measures help an organization be strategy-driven by providing a comparative basis for products, services, business units, and individuals, as well as serving as the anchor for the behavior shaping organizational performance measures.
And you're absolutely correct.
And finally, here's my final
okay.
notes. I think I've been taking good notes here.
Excellent notes.
Making the mission measurable involves seven steps. Number one, senior manager sponsorship. Number two, this is very important, forming a cross-discipline team.
Mm-hmm.
Number three, breaking apart the mission statement into its constituent components. Number four, identifying a measure for each mission component.
Yes.
Number five, combining mission measures as appropriate.
Mm-hmm.
Number six, gaining senior manager approval. And number seven, I love this. I think I copied this down right. Communicate.
Absolutely, Howard.
All right.
Excellent. I think
I got it. Man, I think I'm ready to start my own business here.
Hey,
Well,
you are good. You are all set. But we have more podcasts coming.
all right.
Howard, thank you.
Hey, you're welcome, my friend. I'm glad I could be there for you.
I appreciate it.
All right.
Hey, it feels like we're starting to develop even a style here.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
These are feeling really good. It's going to be hard to go to bed tonight and not like do the post-production on these. So, because I'm going to be diving right in.
I know you are. I know you are. I know you are.
Oh, yeah.
Well, hey, don't stay up too late.
I'll try not to.
Okay.
Howard, thank you.
You're
This
welcome.
is outstanding.
All right.
It's outstanding.
Well, hey, I'd love to get some feedback from you. You're gonna let your sweetheart listen to it?
I will. I'm debating on if I'll let her listen to it beforehand or after
Yeah, wait till after. Wait till you get it in full production mode.
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah,
A
absolutely.
chance to do some editing.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. I'd
Yep.
love to find out what her thoughts were.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, how would I be able to pull it up so I can let Princess check it out?
I can send you the file.
Great.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Yeah. Before and I'll send you the file even before I publish it.
Okay.
I'll send you the file. So
Cool.
yeah. I have no idea how big this file is going to be.
All right. All right. Hey man, have a wonderful night, and this was fun. This was really fun.
This is a lot of fun. I enjoyed this.
We're going national.
We are.
And then
We
we'll
are.
go
Hey,
international.
I was going to say, I've got people, and I think it's 46 countries right now, going to the website.
Fantastic.
We will be international very
Oh,
soon.
wow. Wow. Well, hey, you have a good night.
Hey, you too. Take care. I will see you
Okay.
tomorrow.
See you tomorrow, buddy.
All right. And that wraps us up. Thank you for joining us for this edition of the Strategy Driven Podcast. We look forward to receiving your comments via email at podcast@strategydriven.com. If you enjoyed the show, please consider voting for us on Podcast Alley and visiting our website at www.strategydriven.com. Remember, registered members gain access to the many strategy-driven white papers, models, and members-only categories, such as organizational accountability and decision-making. And registration is always free. Until next time, so long.